he's outsmarted us and that he's not going to get caught.
And you're right, they did out. Your sister outsmarted mm-hmm. with the Snapchat stuff.
Definitely did.
And there's more that they have that's never been released.
Mm-hmm.
I know your grandparents have seen that, and I don't want to ask specifics, but have you seen more?
I haven't.
You haven't. Do you not want to?
I actually didn't know that they were going to see it, or else I probably would have asked to see them.
When they get this guy, what do you want to happen to him at this point?
Well, have you seen The Shack?
I have not, but my father read the book, and I've heard parts of it, but not enough to know, like, what about, tell me how it relates.
So, the little girl is taken from her family, and she is raped and murdered. And in a way, I've always seen myself as the father, because he drifts away from God back and forth, which I do too in some ways, but then they don't find the girl, and then he dies and goes to heaven. And while he's there, God shows him how to forgive. And I hope, not that I could ever forgive what he did, but I hope that he finds forgiveness in that way. But I still really, really hope he gets hurt in prison many times. But that wouldn't be good on my part either.
You're human at the same time.
Yeah.
You know?
So you try to forgive him, but you can't.
Were you raised in a church? Were you religious? Is that a part of your life?
I wasn't. You can't really say that I was raised there because you don't really go to church often. But through everything we've been through, when we were little, what we went through with our parents, I guess I've always been religious and I've always believed in it. And that's kind of what always has gotten me through things. And I think that's where I find most of my strength through everything. So that's why I healed faster than my grandparents did, my grandma did. And that's how I find the strength to go on social media and be out there to people and try to find them.
Sure. That's great. That's great that you have that and that you're finding support mm-hmm. in social media too. You mentioned your parents. So you were raised by your grandparents.
Mm-hmm.
Which is an interesting, different kind of situation. Do you keep in touch with your mom and dad?
My dad actually lives with us.
Oh, he does.
My mom lived in Kentucky and my dad was in and out of prison for a lot of our childhood. So Libby and me actually lived with our grandparents. We ended up with them in a small little town, Delphi. That's super tiny. Everybody knows everybody. Super cute place.
My mom lives in Kentucky.
Was he there today?
He's probably at work right now. He's redoing a house for my grandparents. I don't really keep in touch with my mom because she's one of those people that is doing it for the money, I think, in a way, because...
You mean this case?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. I haven't actually seen any interviews with her.
She's done one for Rafael Sanchez for Channel 6, and she's using psychics to help solve the case.
Yeah, I'm sure psychics come out of the woodwork wanting to mm-hmm. to help. You guys just push them away, no thank you.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. Do you need to get that?
Yeah, it's just a phone call. Hello. Yeah, we're good. Yeah. Love you.
Nice of him to check in.
Mm-hmm. He checks in often.